my name is Beth Hiley here for Board Game Geek at Origins 2019. I'm sitting down with Pete Shirey from Simon Games, and you've brought us Foodies.
Yes, Foodies. So in Foodies, you're a restaurant or a food court manager trying to get the best cuisines and food stalls in your food court to gain the most popularity. So the way you'll do that is, on your turn, you're going to get one of these 10-sided die, and you're going to roll it. And whatever number you roll, everybody will activate that food stall in their food court.
So for five,
you'd get $2 to add to your current money. And then the person who rolled the die would get to choose a cuisine from the market. There's all different types of nationalities. The game comes with 10 nationalities, and each game you will take five cards from the randomizer deck and make the market deck of five of those.
And so, I hope people can see on the overhead, too, that there's actually a little hole in these cards.
Yes.
To let the price peek through. So I thought that was printed with the card originally, and then I thought, wait a minute,
this is not a misprint. This is prototype materials, but yeah, no, this is meant to be there. So when you buy a card from the market, you'll simply just remove it, and then everything will just shift down, and you'll add a new market card.
Because older food is cheaper food.
Older food is cheaper food, absolutely. So once you purchase a card, then you'll place it on your food court, and you can place it anywhere you want. You can even place it over top of previously placed items, and when you do that, now when you roll that number, you will activate that stall instead of the under one. So for instance, in this particular case with American cuisine, if you have the most American cuisine stalls in your food court, you will then get $3. You also notice these stars around here. As you start building more and more cuisine stalls in your food court, now if I were to roll a five, not only would I get that ability, but I'd gain an extra popularity for completing that star. And so the idea is to build a lot of different food cuisines from around the world to give you a good engine for building popularity as well as give you the resources to do so. So as you roll the dice and start gaining popularity, you'll just move this popularity track. Once you've purchased for the turn and we've slid everything down and added a new card to the market, you then get to go to the chefs for hire. So this guy is always on the board, and you can do him more than once, and simply says if you have $4, you can spend it to gain a popularity. These guys,
you're
however,
really banking off of his name.
Yes, he is the chef for hire. And these two guys are special chefs, and these are cards that you'll have to choose from. You'll be able to randomize them or just pick the ones you like. And these can be done once per game, so you have two extra score tokens here. So if you happen to have five different nationalities in your food court, at the end of your turn, you can put your token on there and gain three popularity. And then you can't do that anymore for the rest of the game. This guy here says if I have food stalls,
in
the cross formation, I can get three extra popularity there. So you're probably asking, what are these tokens?
Pete, what are those tokens?
I'm going to tell you what those tokens are. So say, for instance, I rolled that five. And I didn't want to put that one, let's
roll that five.
And say I didn't want to get that five. Say I wanted to do that four instead. I can spend this flyer to, instead of triggering the stall that was rolled, I can choose a stall adjacent to it instead. That way, and it only affects me, everyone else will still activate the stall rolled unless they wish to spend a flyer as well.
It's like get people just close enough to say, come on over here.
Yeah, it's basically the guy at the food court saying, you want this stuff, look at my flyer, it's a good sale here, so you can come over and get that. So that allows you to mitigate the dice rolling a little bit. Now, there's only 9 stalls, as you probably see, and this is a 10-sided die. So let's say you roll a 0. What do you think happens there?
I'm guessing a stall of your choice.
You do. You get to manipulate the die to whatever number you want, and then everyone will then, again, trigger their stall based off of what you...
Oh, well, that's an interesting twist, because then you could very much take a quick glance and figure out which number is less optimal for them's and most optimal for you.
Absolutely, that's the strategy it gets in. Sometimes it may not be your best move, but if it can mess you up or mess him up, absolutely worth it. So now you're probably wondering, how do you win the game?
How do you win the game?
I'm gonna tell you how to win the game. So, in a 2-to-3 player game, once you cross the 20-point threshold of popularity, it triggers the end of the game and you play up to the first player token so everyone has equal turns. On the back side of this board is a 4-to-5 player version, which you would go to 30 points. And then once you cross 30, whoever has the most popularity wins. And then if there's a tie, you would break it with money. And then after that, you just share the victory.
And possibly pie.
And well, there is pie. The Americans have right there.
It's literally called American pie.
It is American
pie. I've only learned that from watching The Great British Bake Off.
Absolutely. Well, that is a good show. My wife loves that show.
Right.
And all the nationalities have different special abilities. So for Americans, all of the American cards will have the same ability. If you have the most American stalls, you get $3. Some of the other abilities that you can see are like the German cuisine. When you place the German cuisine, you get an extra flyer token. And when it's rolled, you'll get $1. For the Italians, you'll get one of these popularity tokens and you'll place it on an adjacent stall. When that's rolled, you'll get that extra popularity. Japanese cuisine, you want to have more Japanese, because when you place the Japanese cuisine, for each Japanese that's adjacent, you get an additional $2. And then, of course, we already saw the Americans, and then the French cuisine. If you have the most French cuisine, you get an additional popularity point. And that's Foodies.
There you go. So if you guys want to check that out, is it available now?
No. So we're demoing it at the Asmodee booth for Origins. We're hoping to have it out before Gen Con. It's going to be $39.99, so it'll be at your friendly local retailers real soon. And we'll definitely have it for demo as well at Gen Con, so you'll be able to see it there. But it should be hopefully in stores before then.
Well, if you guys want to take a look at this, this is Foodies, which is being produced by Simon. This is Pete, and this looks delicious.
Thank you.